right. What is going on tonight? I'm back for some more Grixis Shadow. I'm playing the same main deck that I have been playing, but I changed some cards out in the sideboard. Oh, geez, I gotta turn that down. I added some Liliana of the Veils, so I think it's a better grind card against the Jeskai decks, which have been popping up everywhere. And I changed my mana base to have three blue lands, three watery graves, cut a blood crypt, and then cut radiant flames from my sideboard. And made the anger of the gods radiant flames, excuse me. And then I cut the K command and engineer explosives for a third fatal push and a braid. There's a lot of Jund running around and humans running around. I think that even though EE is good against humans, it can be kind of clunky, and I wanted a spell that I could snap back and it was good in other places. Like, EE is just, it's like, it's always good but never great. Unless you're getting two things, which doesn't always happen. So, I'm gonna jump into a league. And then, hopefully do well. I'm coming off a good 4-1 with this 75. I need to make a cohesive sideboard plan. I believe I like the main deck, but I just don't have a good setup ready for the other aspects of it. Shadow, play points. My stream says that I am offline. Let me just make sure everything's... It says I'm offline, so if there's anybody in the chat, should let me know. I have bitrate going, so I don't really know what's going on. I have people hosting me like I'm online, so I think... good. Today, another list, the same deal in the mix. Yes, that's the goal for today. I had a chance on 5-0 yesterday if I would have countered that Steel Overseer. If I would have just made the proper play, like, that would have been good. But, unfortunately, I was not paying attention and just made a poor play. Okay. Let me move my mic over here. Make sure my audio's good. It's been a struggle recently. Looks like it's registering my voice here. We're good.
Yeah.
Yep.
Yeah.
This hand's all right. We'll keep this. We got a little bit of everything. Actually, I have three different potential turn one plays, which will be interesting. If I was on the play, I would definitely Thoughtseize my opponent. Winds of Teeth, so let's hope this isn't a Boggle. I hope this is just a Noble Hierarch. If this is a Boggle, I'm going to be sad. No, it's a Boggle. Okay. It's not the end of the world. So I need to get my Yes Shadow online. So we're going to fetch... We have two red sources, so I can just get a free watery grave. Okay. So they have... So I think I'm going to take the Spirit Mantle. And hopefully my opponent just gets greedy and plays the core Spirit Dancer to draw a card next turn. But this is going to be difficult to beat. The Gristmoon is going to be difficult to beat as well because it's got evasion. But this is like harder, and it might induce like a poor play for them to go like Gristmoon into Scout, and next turn Scout Boon. Or Core Spirit Dancer into Scout Boon. So we're going to take the Mantle. Oh, yeah, Paulo. Nice. Yeah, Magic Hero, thank you. I tend to play pretty slowly. Which I definitely lose some viewers because of my pace of play. Yeah, see, we're going to... Okay, see, they go for it. So this is going to kind of help slow them down a little bit. Oh, thank you. Much appreciated, buddy. Enjoy your emote there. That's my dog, Philly. He's the cutest dog on Twitch. I will argue with anybody that says differently. That's actually a fantastic draw. So now we push this, go get another watery grave and get our shadow down. So we need gas to come off the top. Like, we don't need to draw any more lands. That fetch land was actually a pretty good draw. But we're gonna need something here. So, okay, so we know two out of three cards. We're just looking for, basically looking for Battle Rage. There's not a whole lot of stuff that's gonna matter besides Battle Rage at the moment. So here comes a 2-1. And we easily can outrace this if they miss. Yep. So we're gonna have at least one Bogle here. Okay, so they're holding up the Dryad Arbor. That's a really good draw. So I think I'm gonna start by Seer Envisioning before I do anything with my lands. Lightning Bolt's not bad. So if I go Shock, if I leave this Lightning Bolt on top, shock myself to 6, attack, they chump. They attack me back to 8. Right, they attack me for 2 more. I go to 5. My shadow's 8. I can bolt them to 12. The turn after that, I'm one short of killing them the next turn, assuming that they don't have anything. But if they fetch here, they have to bottom both of these. And I actually have to be kind of careful with my life total, because this Lightning Bolt covers a Dryad Arbor, but I need to get two, I need to connect twice with a shadow to win the game. This is pretty tough. I know this is going on the bottom. I could just hit them for 4. They go to 11. My opponent, like, not shock myself, just hold a land. My opponent then cracks me for some damage, at least 3 on the board. 4, I go to 5. Then I shock myself to 3, and I'm still short. I think I have to put this on top because I'm going to have to kill the Dryad Arbor. Oh, this is so tough. I kind of wish I would attack first before I cast this, because then at least I'd have the information what my opponent did. Yeah, look at that emote there. I think I'm going to put this on top. I'm going to shock. Attacking. This is a very tough set of turns here. I assume they block. I'm at an Inquisition. I don't think there's much I can hit with this, because they would have cast any 2-mana enchant. This is probably a land or another creature. Could be something like a Core Spirit Dancer. Okay, so there's a Dryad Arbor. Yeah. Okay, so we hit a Bogle, which is nice. The problem here again is we can only hit them for 13 next turn. We can't kill them. So we get that out of here. Kind of interesting what my opponent does, because if they block with this Dryad Arbor and they use this Dryad Arbor to sack a land to have a draw, then they cut themselves off a decent amount of draws. because they're just down that many lands. If my opponent attacks, even with just the Glade Cover Scout, there are definitely draws that kill them. Like, we obviously know that our draw doesn't because we have a Lightning Bolt on top, but they have draws. Like, if they're playing around what I could draw, they get, and the card I kept on top, that's bold. Alright, so I just attack. I can't shock myself or anything. So I just get in here. And then the big question is, do I bolt this Dryad Arbor? And I don't think I do. I'll bolt the Dryad Arbor if they attack, I think. But I could do it now. Alright, so I think my opponent missed. If they hit, they would be, they would have already strapped it on. Okay? Right now? Do you mind taking them out right now? Right, thank you. Now I think I want to bolt the, now never mind. That doesn't matter. Because they draw land. Sorry, yeah, puppy's all excited. Yeah, we're just gonna let this happen. Did I miss it or did they miss it? I'm actually going to bolt this inside of combat, because if they don't have a land, like, I'm going to put a stop on combat there. Oh my god, I did miss it. Did I? 2, 11. Did I? Are we just like shaking off the dust this morning? This afternoon. Yep, I did. Chalk. Yeah, I would have done it. No, I made a mistake. I'm going to bolt this before we get out of combat, though. Because if they have a 2-mana, if they have a 2-mana, creature here to block, this cuts this off. No, yeah, I made a mistake there. I just miscounted the first game of the night. There. So now my opponent... There's the land. Yep. Well, we weren't punished for it, but I did miss it there. I like to think that I didn't miss it. I just wanted to give them a chance, you know? Like, I was just being polite, you know? All right, so against Bogles, we don't really have a lot of good stuff to bring in. Like, the Stubborn Denials are decent. The Liliana of the Veils are great. And I actually like to bring in Radiant Flames because, A, I have a lot of cards to bring out. Like, I cut my Dismembers. I cut my Fatal Pushes. So I might not be able to bring the Radiant Flames in with this configuration. They're going to have four... Rest in pieces. We don't need this K command. I'm going to cut a Snapcaster Mage. Or probably should cut Gurmag Angler. And bring these in. So what I like about Radiant Flames is that oftentimes they like dilute their deck a little bit to have some more interaction. And they might keep a hand that like is very interactive, but it only has creatures and not a lot of enchantments. And a lot of the times, like a sweeper can interact with those enchantments. So... Hopefully we tighten up for this game. And I just cut an Angler because Angler's kind of oftentimes small ball and like they're gonna have Rest in Pieces. And at least I can flash Snapcaster Mage in. So yeah, this hand's pretty great. We just need a Death Shadow. This hand's not even that bad against a Ley Line because we have Battle Rage. So we're gonna keep this. They kept two, so they lay line me. Which kind of sucks. But if they go ley line into Boggle plus like a good amount of equipment, I'm gonna struggle to win this game. Nope, don't do a moto. Okay, nice. That was almost bad. So let's fetch. Now I'm all nervous, almost clicking through my turns here after I made a mistake. I like Radiant Flames too. It's much easier to, like, the exile really isn't that relevant. And I think the double red is actually relevant. Okay, so we don't want this, and we don't want this. So we hit the Radiant Flames. So if they kept a hand that's like a bunch of dudes and not a lot of pants, then the Radiant Flames will be able to make up for it or catch me up. But it looks like they had a ley line into a functional hand, which is going to be tough to beat no matter what. Okay, so there's Hyena Umbra into Ethereal Armor. Okay, so we basically need Death Shadow now. If we draw Death Shadow, we're going to win this game, because I'm just going to Battle Rage over them and just kill them in one shot. Yeah, that's not good. And again, the Liliana does not do anything because of this Ley Line. I don't think I can mulligan my hand. Like, on the draw, my hand's pretty solid. Yep, they all go up on YouTube, unless there's something weird going on. What do we got? We got anything else here, bud? And this is hands, like, Death Shadow's not going to win these kind of games. Jeez. We're not cracking this fetch land. First strike, trample. So we can win if my opponent's card in their hand is a dud. But we can't even win because we need to draw a red source that's not fetchable. Yeah. Yeah, thank you for the sub there, Magic Cheerio. I appreciate it. You'll be able to check it out on YouTube in probably in the morning. I'll set it up before I go to bed, but it might not come through. Okay. I'm just going to run it back here. This isn't like a play draw matchup. All the cards are good. No matter where you are. Like to play first, and this hand's pretty good. We've got a kind of a slower Death Shadow, but we have a couple pieces of interaction, one that interacts even through ley line. So I'm gonna keep this hand. We're just gonna hope that we don't get ley lined again here. And like, the Radiant Flames is relevant because if we can stub our way out of, you know, this creature's getting too big, we might be able to get the creatures and the Radiant Flames. Boggles. Yeah. Okay, sweet. So we're not getting ley lines. Their hand's got to be very good, if I would assume. It's probably very redundant. So this gets red-black. I'm going to start off on blue-black, even though I have another one in hand. You get messed up in this deck if you don't get the red-black, in my opinion. One land. Okay, so now this is just the easiest... Glade Cover Scout, because that's their only duder. There's the Heath. I swear to God, if they crack this fetch line, no way. They draw a Boggle. I'm gonna be so sad if my opponent drew a Boggle. If they drew a Boggle, we still can play around it though. No, they're just getting this tapped. Okay, nice. Alright. I'll probably get Steam Vents with this land. This gives us the 4. So I can play Death Shadow next turn. Okay, so my opponent doesn't have anything. I'm actually not going to fetch. Alright, that's the next best draw for us. So there's our Steam Vents. 14, 12, Death Shadow. And now the only thing that we're looking for is a way to increase the clock. they draw land, they're gonna be able to Core Spirit Dancer, which is okay. So they found a Boggle. I'm actually gonna attack into the Boggle because I will trade with a Tier Battle Rage here if I can, or I'll just draw the best card in my deck. We have an interesting point, interesting thing to discuss next turn, potentially. Okay, so they hit. So now I've got to think about what to do with this Core Spirit Dancer. I'm definitely going to attack, and if they block, I'm going to Battle Rage. If they don't block, I think I'm just going to, like, okay, so that makes everything so much easier. So we're 4 damage, we're gonna fetch, Radiant Flames, and I guess I'm gonna tick up and ditch the Battle Rage. The Battle Rage does increase my clock, but we have all the tools to win this game regardless. We don't need the Battle Rage. So let's go blue, red, black, Radiant Flames, tick my Liliana up. And I would keep the Battle Rage if I didn't have this Liliana. If again, like if I didn't have the Liliana, I'd keep the Battle Rage and I would ditch a stub. But the Liliana has a creature, the next creature covered. This now in case we hit a fetch land, we hit a Snapcaster. That Snapcaster is just more copies of Stubborn Denial, so I'm not really worried about it. I guess we can just put on top in case anything weird happens, and then I'm just gonna leave my Liliana on too. Yeah, I can't beat the humans deck when I play this version of Death Shadow. Or play the Traverse Death Shadow, I just can't beat the humans deck. I like the Traverse Death Shadow deck probably across the format slightly better than the Grixis Shadow deck, but I just can't beat the humans. Like, that's the biggest problem. It's like if you can't beat humans, then what are you doing? Because the deck's so popular. Okay, then we got lethal on the board. We can flash a Snapcaster Mage in, so we have lethal through two blockers. Guess it doesn't matter. It literally doesn't matter. Let's stop the next thing. I could have just let that resolve, flash my Snapcaster Mage in. All right. That's a good way to start the night out with the W. We're gonna get a 5 Elder Sleek, I can feel it. I'm actually gonna grab myself some water while we wait for the next round. I'm gonna try to stand away from the mic while I'm a Kiwi here. Maybe I'll mute myself while I'm eating.
Yeah, that's what I'll do.
Okay. I think my best play here is to fetch a Blood Crypt and just Inquisition my opponent. Look to hit like a... I assume that we're playing against regular Tron, because I don't think Eldrazi Tron's that good. So like I always kind of hedge and play. Like I can handle Eldrazi Tron, I don't think I can beat up the other Tron decks very well. Mine. They just got it rolled up. Alright. How do I like the Jeskai control matchup? How do you beat the Jeskai control matchup? I think if you really want to beat the Jeskai control deck, you need to... That's what they play. They play the tower. They play the power plant. You gotta have Liliana of the Veils in your sideboard. And like, while that card might not be great at the moment in other places, I think you need it against Jeskai. So now we're just digging for a critter. All right, that one's bad. This game's gonna be on hard mode. All right, well there's a dude. There's another dude. Yeah, I think we're flashing a Snapcaster Mage at the end of the turn. That's how this game's gonna go. They play their tower, yeah. So I know two out of three cards. So they probably drew an Ancient Stern with their last draw. This is like desperation. I'll cast this. The only card that they could have that it's going to hit they wouldn't have played would be an Ulamog. But hitting an Ulamog will be important. Alright, so we have nothing. Alright, we're just going to hope that for another 10 turns they just miss. There's a Sanctum. Ooh. Little Karn. So I'm gonna give my opponent the power plant. I'm gonna attack this Karn next turn. So I'm gonna attack my opponent, and then I'm gonna bolt the Karn, and then I'm gonna battle rage over the Karn next turn. I think. Yeah. Baby Karn. I guess I could. No, they would just pop this. So they would put a fake counter on this. Bold self, go ham. There's not a lot of ham to go at the moment. This is just a pretty unfortunate set of circumstances we have going on. Put a card you own from the silver counter exile into your hand. Okay. So they're getting back their Chromatic Star. Yeah, I think we need to go to the next game, Rafi. I think that's where we're at here. Now I can just like innocently attack the Karn. Opponent only has 8 mana here. I gotta get rid of Nightbot. Oh baby, we're gonna get to stub this. Yes, we're gonna get to stub this thing. This is great. We just have to deal with an Ulamog next turn. Alright, ready? We're gonna draw a Thoughtseize off the top, and then we're gonna win. That's the game plan here. Alright, there's a redraw for a Thoughtseize. Nope. Nope. No good. Things that I have not. I've beaten and resolved Ulamog one time. So against this deck, I want this, this, and all of these. Cards I'm not interested in. My dismembers. My fatal pushes. My lightning bolts. And I can cut one Gurmag Angler. I could leave a couple lightning bolts and shave Snapcaster Mage. Because they're gonna have graveyard hate. And like a quick angler might be a way to steal a game. We're gonna go on the play that Quick Angler is more reliable than Snapcaster Mage. I could leave the bolts in because it's, you know, I can bolt myself and it's explosive, but. Alright. They might Eldrazi. I think I can. I'll just. The Eldrazi plan is not very good against these Death Shadow decks because your creatures are just larger than theirs are. Let me keep this. I'm actually not going to fetch on turn one because I want this to be a Blood Crypt. This is like the patron sacrilegiousness of Serum Visioning. Alright, we don't need another one of those. And we're gonna want this if things go well. We already have two counter spells that matter. I'll put this on the bottom. The only thing that's gonna realistically hit is like it's gonna hit next turn. It'll hit Sylvan Scrying. That the other cards won't hit. Why I'm much more afraid of this version of the deck. Alright. I'm much more afraid of this version of the deck than. Oh, we hit an Angler and a Death Shadow? What a joke. I like holding those, but we're in a tough enough position where I want to just start casting some stuff. So let's go get Blood Crypt. So hopefully we can take a big fatty. Or they maybe just don't have Tron. Power plants. They're gonna have Tron. So they've got. Can take this Baloth. Urges power plant. So they're gonna have this. So I might as well just take. I think the Thought Knots here is more scary than the Karn. Though they're both. I'm gonna have to counter both of them, but we'll just take this one. There's the power plant. Push this now. They get the tower. Yeah, I know. Yeah, I'm not gonna take the Baloth. I should play the island and pass. Just gonna counter the Karn. This is spicy in this deck. I don't know if it's really good in this deck, but it's cool. Reject. rejection. If this is an O stone, I'll hit it with the other rejection. It's just the map. Con Sion Aversa. Yeah, I think. So I could get aggressive and hit this in order to try to keep them off of like Sanctum of Ugin mana or Ulamog mana. Because I have a Snapcaster Mage for another threat.
I could just be aggressive. So what does this go get? This goes get Sanctum.
Yeah, I can't take him home with me. Like, we have the Snapcaster Mage to reuse. If I find, like, I gotta find a threat quickly. I think I wanna just kinda, like, harass my opponent on the axes that I can. So. Let's cast this. Actually, that might wind up with a Baloth in play. You think I just thought sees him? Rafi, I'm tempted to do this just because you say that I won't. Yeah. I'm doing this just because Rafi says I won't do it. Look at that. Look what we sniffed out here. God, I'm so good at this game. We're just going to take a Ulamog. Then we're going to snap rejection this Karn. Oh yeah, and we got the clock. The clock is on. We even got a Battle Rage. This is only a 9-turn clock. All right, that's terrible, actually, because this freaking Baloth.
I could just play it
and then hold it there, which I'm actually gonna do. Just not gonna use it, just gonna get our Liliana in play. Nice. All right, don't kill my Snapcaster. What a jerk. What a jerk. We're not gonna 5-0 this league, guys. It's just not gonna happen. Yep, just it's just not gonna happen. Wasn't meant to be. How do I play deck? There's no decks. There is no deck that is like clearly better than any other deck besides humans. I think that humans is the only deck in the format that is like not average. There are certain decks that do very well against humans that you can get lucky and do well with. I think the Jeskai decks are like that. Oh, I know this guy. This guy is going to the Pro Tour, I think. Oh, give me 1 second, Maurice, call me. I think I'm gonna mulligan my hand. This hand is not that great. This hand's decent. We need a land. Bottoming anything, it's not a land. Might have kept a Seer Visions. Okay, island. Okay, that's a good draw. So let's. I'm showing you a blood crypt. The reason why I'm fetching is because this enables, if I draw another fetch land next turn, I can go double shadow. Okay. Well, that's not good because we're going to be all spreading seas. Maybe we're just going to take a spreading seas and then try to like mana screw my opponent here. I'm just playing blue white. At least they got rid of our red source, which I mean that's a worse land to get for them to hit. Okay. Just gonna pass. Which Jeskai decent is human superiority to mana denial. What makes Jeskai good against humans is the What makes Jeskai good against humans? Jeez, man. Alright, we have to Snapcast our Thoughtseize. What makes Jeskai good against humans is that Jeskai has both the spot removal to pick off their synergy creatures, and it can wipe away all the things that don't necessarily matter. God, this is gross. I just can't win. I'm gonna take this Supreme. I'm gonna take this Cryptic Command. Then I'm just gonna try to like slog through all this stuff here. They can't even cast. So he's very real Field of Ruin me into being able to cast this. Wall of Omens, what a beating. So I have a feeling I'm gonna need this Dismember to win. Like some kind of an explosive attack. But I kind of want this land to be able to get a red source here. Yeah, this is just like, this is terrible. You need the Lilianas to compete in this kind of a game, I think. I just don't know. The Dismembers, this Colonnade is going to become a problem eventually. I would like red mana, but I don't really need it. Like, it's not really, like, that's kind of the least of my worries. I think the only way that I'm going to win this game is to get lucky with, like, a Dismember. So, next turn, if I Dismember this, I go down, take 4 life, go to 5. My shadows are 8, which is 16, which isn't quite enough. So, I'm just going to hit this. Swing in, and I'm going to play a Death Shadow. Give my opponent enough, like, to feel okay about Supreme Verdicting. No, I should have just ditched the Dismember. That was just stupid. I should have hoped they don't have the double white. That was just stupid. And my whole thought was, like, the Dismember is, like, maybe going to be able to, like, explode me for a turn to come out with, like, 8 points of damage out of nowhere. But in all reality, all my opponents need a white source, and I can no longer attack into them, and I can no longer, like, play creatures. So I need, like, I need a bunch of Thought Seizes, or a bunch of, Stubborn Denials. So I don't have 2. I only have 2 in the main deck. Jace the Mind Sculptor. Okay. They still have Path to Exile up. Yeah, they got Jace. That Jace is enough here. We're gonna go to the next game here. We do have some good tools to help here. Like, yeah, I just wasn't thinking there enough. We can bring this in. Like, these 7 cards are pretty aces. Then we can get rid of some of like the garbage out of our deck. Like, this Battle Rage is garbage. The pushes are garbage. The bolts are garbage. I can keep the pushes in to be able to answer like a colonnade. Like, that's potential. I guess the dismembers. Like, the odds, the games are going to slow down after sideboard a little more because I can actually interact on an axis that they play on much better. Like, we just have 4. Like, we have these 5 cards here are going to do some serious work for us. We should make sure not get like rest in peace out of this game, because rest in peace is really not good. This is the easiest way to get this, the game just turned off before it even starts. God, like I said, we were at a 5-0. Now we're on the verge of being 1-2. This is what I get. I would like to play first. Oh yeah, I'm all again. If this hand produced blue mana, if this land produced blue mana, I would keep it. But alas, it does not. Okay. Doesn't really matter what this card is. Yeah, it's not worth me not thought seizing them, I think. Because like this just allows me to disrupt my opponent next turn, Thought Scour into either a Gurmag Angler or a Death Shadow. They put a card on top. So this sucks. Because they're going to be able to draw out of this. So I'm just going to take the Spreading Seeds because it's one that messes me up the most. That Wall of Omens is just so annoying. This card is terrible, I think. In the modern format, it's just very good against this deck. But I guess the format's more fair. So, like, I should bite my tongue. Because here comes the land, and then here comes the wall. Yep. I just gotta push the wall. Like, it's ugly, but it's the world that we live in currently. And then I'm going to hold that because I think I want to Thought Seize my opponent here. And I think I'm just going to get a basic. I just don't want to, like, I guess I have plenty more Snapcasters in my deck to draw to kill his Colonnade later in the game. This is just tough. This is like probably the worst matchup for these Death Shadow decks. Okay, Path to Exile, Detention Sphere, Wall of Omens. Yeah, I'm just going to take the Wall of Omens. Just maybe they'll get stuck on mana for a little while. Maybe they'll use one of these dumb removal spells to take out my Snapcaster Mage. Like, the Wall of Omens just smooths them out. This is such a clunky deck. All right. I should cycle my Thought Scout, my Street Wraith on my turn. Because if I hit a Death Shadow, I guess it doesn't really matter. I'm just going to hold this for a flash thing. So I might as well hold this thing as well. Or I can go like snap Serum Visions in order to try to get them to blow a Detention Sphere or a Verdict on this, but I don't really have anything else going on. Yeah, I guess it's just like the best thing that I am doing. At least these are replacing themselves. There's like not a lot going on. I think this is just a really poor deck. All right. Last Hope's good, so put this on the bottom, put this on top. Like, I think that this deck here is just a much, much worse version of, like, Jeskai. Okay, so they're going to be able to verdict me. Detention Sphere. Huh. Okay. I think I would have rather like see a verdict from my opponent there. But I guess verdict allows them to like rebuy some cards and like maybe they're thinking they're gonna be able to hit this with this colony. Okay. Alright, so they don't really have a lot going on. It's right on time. And I guess I start to try and interact. Gonna take the verdict. I'm I'm going to not cycling this because I have to stay above life. I just hope that they brick off on spells or brick off on ways to interact with this Liliana. I mean, lands. But it doesn't appear like that's going to be the case. We want our opponent to draw nothing but, like, something dumb for the rest of the game, like cryptic commands or rest in pieces. But this game's more than likely over. If my opponent hits a land, it's probably over. Wall of Omens isn't great. Because it's like kind of a land. Yeah, see, there's now the colonies are turned on. Now I need to hit running fatal pushes. Basically. I guess I should have done that to my opponent. Just would have been proper sequencing. Yep, I went to GPDC. Yep, I did not do very well. I think my opponents and I think we misbuilt my deck. Like I went 6-2 or 7-1 on day one because like my teammates were better limited players than I was, so I had the best deck. I think we could have like taken away from my deck a little bit. Alright, this is probably coming at me. Yeah. I like that play for my opponent. Yeah. Should have said hi, man. All right, yeah, we're good here. Ooh, rough start. We just got demolished. And I think, like, I think it's okay to lose to this deck. There's not a lot we can do against that deck. And that deck's just not very good. Like, the Jeskai deck, you have a much better Jeskai matchup than you do against that blue-white deck. I think a blue-white deck is just, like, really... I've thought that it's garbage for a long time. I think that it's good if you can pick, like, I don't know, if you can get rid of, like, 8 decks from the metagame, then the deck would be very good, but unfortunately that's just not how Modern works. I appreciate everybody showing up and hanging out tonight. We're going to play at least one league, might play 2 leagues with how fast this is going. Archmage, how you doing? Archmage and I have this terrible relationship about how I crap on his deck all the time. Oh, here we go. The funny thing is that I crap on that deck. That deck always destroys me. Yeah, we're gonna mulligan. This thing's pretty good. I think we're going to... I actually don't think we want this Snapcaster Mage. I wish I knew what my opponent was playing. Because if it's like something grindy, I want this Snapcaster Mage, or it's something linear, I don't think I want this. I think I'm going to put it on top. Just because it's like a very good card. But it does anti-synergize with my Angler, and I need one more land. Oh, that was you? I should have verdicated the 2 Snapcaster Mages and still the DCO. Yes. That was you I was playing against. That's what I thought. I thought it was either you or another one of my friends. So I'm glad we kept our Snapcaster Mage there. We're going to trade all over the place here. And I think I'm going to take my opponent's Thoughtseize. If it wasn't me, I would have been giving advice in chat. Yeah, I was very surprised when you didn't verdict my Snapcaster Mages. I was surprised. I was hoping you were so that I could rebuy them with Liliana. Okay. So that's okay. Because we have a Snapcaster, but I'm gonna cycle this now. Shouldn't have played my land. This is missequenced. Yeah. So let's fetch here. I'm going to get. I'm gonna get a blood crypt. I'm gonna get like punished if I draw exactly another cantrip, which I didn't. Polluted Delta. So I want this land, but I don't want this Thought Scour. So let's put this land out because this land is gonna allow us to start doing Snapcaster things. Okay, so they're gonna be able to start lingering souls, maybe. I could just take this Faithless Looting, which I'm kind of tempted to do. Because I really want to be able to throw them off kilter, getting like things down in front of my angler. So I think I'm actually going to take Faithless Looting. Then I'm probably going to fetch a tap land and delve, or fetch a basic and delve angler, leaving like Inquisition and Serum Visions in my graveyard. They draw Faithless Looting. Well, they draw. They drew Young Pyromancer. Okay. Well, they drew Brutality. All right. Well, that doesn't really do anything. They just nugged me. Okay. So just have K Command and one other card. The problem is if I play my Snapcaster Mage, if I don't, now I feel like I have to fetch and get this K Command out of here. Because they're just going to, I guess I also could just hope they don't hit their land, which I think is what I'm going to do. So we're going to go get, we're just going to keep our mana good. We're going to get, this tapped. One, two, three. I don't think we're gonna have time to bring back this K Command. Thoughtseize is too much damage. So if I can get away with it, I'm going to. What is this? Is this a thing, way to kill this? No, they just flash my Lingering Souls. Okay. That's not good. So I think I snap Serum Visions. I think I'm at the point where I can't really afford to interact with what my opponent's doing. And just try to race to find a Death Shadow. But I'm going to hold this in case I draw a Death Shadow or something I can cast right now. Because I don't want to take the life. And I want to be able to play around K-Command. Alright, we drew Serum Visions. I don't think I want any of these cards. And I'm not going to cast my Serum Visions right now. It's just going to be K-Command fodder. And hopefully we just they just miss a land drop and you just turn these things sideways for the rest of the game. Alright. So we got what? Bolts coming in here. Everywhere. No, so they hit the land. Thoughts use my Seer Visions, which is fine. They can bedlam me next turn, but they'd have to ditch their K Command. Oh, that was a big time draw. And so we just barely got enough going on here to put enough pressure on our opponent. I wouldn't be surprised if this gets Fatal Push. I think their last card in hand is either a Lightning Bolt or a Fatal Push. Like if I had to try to figure out or put a bead on what they have left. Yeah. That just kills me, because then they just K-Command me out of the game here. They attack for one, and then they just kill me with the K-Command. All right. Let's give this post-sideboard game a little whirl. So I actually, on the play, like bringing in all of my Lilianas. Where I don't like the Lilianas on the draw, the Veils on the draw. I like Liliana of the Veil on the play because it can hit a Young Pyromancer. and it can just start to chew through things. Like, if it hits Pyromancer, it's fine. I don't like my Fatal Pushes. I don't like my Battle Rages. I like Sunbolt. Dismember's okay. And the game's gonna get long, real long, so we can just cut Street Wraith. I think I like Street Wraith better than some of these Stubborn Denials, though. I'm not sure I need all of my Lightning Bolts, so maybe we should have some Stubborn Denials in. Just like playing Stubborn Denial against like the Lingering Souls deck just seems gross. But I'm playing Liliana the Veil, so. But I like this card on the play. It's not going to be in my deck on the draw. But on the play, it can provide a little bit of... It can provide enough pressure, I think. It comes down as Edict of Pyromancer. So... I was listening to JRT's podcast, and he thinks that these Martyr Pyromancer decks, with humans being so good, should be playing... should be playing Gutshot. Alright, I don't think I can mulligan a hand like this. Like, we have two threats. They're going to be able to get online soon. And if you mulligan against the discard deck, it's just it's so bad. Alright, that's a spell. Okay, so we're going to go Faithless Living here. I'm going to fetch this tapped. Double Lingering Souls. Nice. Soul Power. All right. I'm just going to play this now. I'm going to bolt a Soul's Token, then Edict the other Soul's Token. Like, it's not pretty, but it's just something that I have to do to chew through these Lingering Souls. That's just so much card advantage for my opponent when they do that. Hopefully they play a Young Pyromancer. Thoughtseize. Okay. That Thoughtseize seems kind of odd. Unless you have something else to do with your mana right here, unless you're worried about Last Hope. I might bolt my opponent. Okay, now we can delve that. That's interesting. So we're going to be able to play Angler next turn. I probably should be like an adult and fetch a blue source. But like a blue, like an island. So they ditch their Fatal Pushes and Marsh Flats. Yeah, I'm going to fetch an island. No, I should fetch a swamp. That was stupid. Because I have another Angler. Yeah, this is, even though I'm giving away information, I didn't do this right. Hopefully my opponent doesn't Liliana me, but I would assume they're just going to be flashing back Lingering Souls. Then, like, with the help of this Angler and this Snapcaster Mage, we might be able to just chew through what my opponent has going on here. They have six cards already in the graveyard. They can Bedlam Revelry. Red, red. Yeah, they ditched three cards to do that, though. I guess they didn't do anything. All right. I can actually bolt snap bolt this thing. Yeah, I think I'm going to do that. And then just get in there with the Angler. Flash this in. I'm definitely going to need like a Thought Scour or something like that to be able to power out this Gurmag Angler. Because it's just going to need a little bit more pressure than what I have going on so far. But Gurmag Angler is tough to kill. So it's probably double another Pyromancer. Okay. Pyromancer into Mega Bunch tokens. Yep. So we're going to take this Kolaghan's command, and then we're just serving with both of our guys. If my opponent wants to trade, it's the same thing on offense or defense. The only thing we can do here is like lean on our opponent. There's not, like, this is just, we're in a tough spot. Okay, so we're just going to take two to keep their flyers. It's not worth me flashing in a Snapcaster Mage to Thoughtseize this Inquisition. Just gonna get this in play. God, this is gonna be rough jumping into the league after this. Because I think we're in trouble this game. We have some outs. My opponent's just gonna start making tokens for days. If I draw a fetch land, I can fetch my swamp and then get an angler into play. I'll trade here if I get the opportunity to, which I don't. Thing is, these two trade here and they can just chump this angler if they need to. Alright, that's pretty good. So let's think. If I attack, they go block, block. This goes up. Block, block, up on here. What happens if I just send in? Alternatively, I can just attack with everything, take on the Pyromancer. Because they probably just go block, block, and then the problem is if they do that, they go block, block, take five. That's kind of dangerous. Or you just chump all of these. Because they can just ignore the Liliana. But then they're dying to the angler. I think I have to kill the Pyromancer this turn, I think, to have any chance. So I think what I do is I serve him with my team, and I tick up on the Pyromancer. Yeah, I think that's what we do here. They probably trade. They're just doing chump block. Chump block trade, okay. The only thing that this does here is if I find, like, I can roll back the Snapcaster Mage next turn to try to figure something out, or if, like, they try to split their difference here, because they can't just attack me with everything. They need to be able to impact the board, or they're going to die to the Gurmag Angler. This is going to be a tight one. Basically, if they find anything, it's actually not that tight. If they find anything, we're going to die quickly. It looks like they're just flashing back looting. The Dreadmoor, the Angler, is not good. Because then they don't have to block next turn. It's been going pretty well, but this league has not been great. So I need like a Radiant Flame, so they just have a Lightning Bolt. Yeah. Whew. We got ran over. In that league, I got cocky after the first round. I think I have time for one more league here. We went 2-1 to start that did not win a game. Oh, nope, we're gonna drop from this. I'm just gonna run back the same one here. That was just like, I think that was just a tough set of rounds there. Just gonna jump back into that. here. Let's pull the deck up here. I guess while we are chilling out, I appreciate everybody for showing up and hanging out tonight. My name is Dylan Hovey. You guys are on my stream here. If you guys like what you see, please hit the follow button. If you want to support me more, go over to my YouTube channel and subscribe there. It's free. It's the best way to support me. If you guys want to support farther, you can get the subscriptions. Just keeps things going, keeps more incentive. You guys check out Gamer Craze and Card Hoarder as they are sponsors of the stream, and they are the two best. You know what they do. What they do is the best. They're very good at what they do. The Card Hoarder team is great, and Gamer Craze buys and sells at a very competitive rate. Take it easy. No, I don't really like ley lines, to tell you the truth. Yeah, we can keep this hand. Yeah, we can keep this. I'm gonna wait on my Street Wraith until next turn because I could draw, like, or if my opponent plays, like, a bird here. Okay, Ink Moth Nexus. Okay, it's playing its affinity. No, I'm not like I said, I'm not a very big Leyline fan. Yeah, we're just going to, no matter what I cycle into here, I'm going to Thought Scour anyway, so I might as well just hold this Street Wraith, especially considering my life total is going to be under damage or duress. Would we get the Mythic Angler plus Death Shadow draw? Yeah, I think so. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6, 7, yeah. So let's go get our black source. Cycle. Yeah, I would rather, so if I wanted to play Graveyard Hate, I would play a card like Spell Bomb because, like, there's going to be times when against either of those decks, the Graveyard Hate doesn't really matter. And I would rather have something that cantrips because it's very low risk in order to do it like that. So I do need a removal spell here to deal with that. That's not good. For you, another 4-1. I think that the Cavs will get a game. I would bet on the Cavs, though. Like, I think the Cavaliers are, I think the odds are in their favor enough. I'm just going to flash the Snapcaster Mage at the end of the turn, probably. Like, at 10-1, I would bet on the Cavaliers. Like, I think it's very slim, their chances are, but, like, those are good odds, I think. Okay. So by flashing the Snapcaster Mage, they are going to have to block something. And the Snapcaster Mage isn't doing anything. Shock. So if I shock, they have to block something other than the Death Shadow. So they have to block the Death Shadow or the Angler. So they either lose one of these. Do you favor Grixis Death Shadow over Forge? Yes, I do. Because I just don't think that you can beat. I don't think the Jund Shadow deck can routinely beat the Humans deck. So I definitely lose to something like. I lose to Red Source Galvanblast. But I can just flash the Snapcaster Mage and block. So I think that's what I'm going to do in order to play around the Galvanblast. So flash this in, because this means that they have to block both of these and one of these. If I attack, They probably go block, 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 grow. If I find a removal spell, I just win.
Get a level, yeah.
What do you see? Yeah, basketball's a lot of fun. So is it worth cycling or just casting the Street Wraith? I've got, how many cards do I have that win the game? I've got two pushes, three lightning bolts, two dismembers, one Kolaghan's Command. So I have eight cards that win me the game. I've got eight cards, two, four, six redraws. So I have 14 out of 42 that are good. That's probably not good enough odds. If I just attack with both of these, they have to chump block with something. They have to block both of them. So like this plus this goes under the bus, and I can just cast Street Wraith and then line it up next turn. Yeah, I think we're gonna wait here. If I attack with everything though, then I can block the Steel Overseer next turn because they probably put creature here, creature, creature here, creature here, creature. Probably put this here, and this guy here. Then their last creature standing is a Steel Overseer. Yeah. TBR too, so there was like, yeah, so there's the, that's what the block we knew was gonna happen. Anyway, their Nexus. And then we're going Death Shadow on hard mode. And now we they need to present three blockers. Come on, Mr. Wizards of the Coast. Who is this one? Watsy Coverage. Coop. I don't know who that is. I'm proud of that attack, by the way. I don't know. I think it's a good play. Yeah, we're just going to block here because we don't want to get Galv Blasted. Pretty sure that's the only way we lose. Yeah. So they had the Galv Blast. The K command for the Rubbins. Okay, so Fatal Push, Lavamancer, a Braid, Liliana of the Last Hope, and Rejections. I like cutting Street Wraith. I like shaving a bunch of Anglers because Angler just gets kind of small balled because they have a lot of Etch Champions and you can't really battle range on the top of it. I don't like Stubborn Denials. And I can cut probably like two Thought Seizes. All right, I'm gonna grab some water. Be right back. Keep this hand. I wish I had a tri-land I could fetch for on turn one. I really want to draw a land here so I don't have to fetch. Or I don't have to cantrip. Because if I don't draw a cantrip, I'd probably, if I don't draw a land, I'd probably have to cantrip on one. Okay, Springleaf Drum. Ever considered Bone Picker? No, it really doesn't cross my mind. Yeah, I'm just going to push this before they can put it on the Ink Moth. Because I actually don't mind them loading up this Memnite. because it's just going to enable my shadow if my draw continues to be kind of anemic. Like, they just go sack, sack, sack over here, then whatever. Yeah. You want Souls on the sideboard of the white deck, of the Grixis deck, or are you playing like a Jund deck? Okay, so this is quite the board presence. That's everything. So we're really susceptible to an Ink Moth kill here. All right, so that's nice. So let's... put on the bottom. Put on top. I think I'm gonna bolt this now. I think I should have put my bolt on the bottom because now they can just like activate, activate, make Ink Moth a land, and then move everything over. So I'm gonna hope they don't do that. They're just gonna make this large also. Which this is also fine. Yeah, they're just gonna make this thing big, okay. So now they can't even animate their Ink Moth. Oh, they can, because of the opal. Okay, so now we can get Death Shadow down. We have another bolt coming, so we can actually have the Ink Moth covered. So actually, this kind of worked out decent for us. Yeah, this actually worked out pretty great. I think it might have been there risk it for the biscuit. Like, I started noticing that after we're gonna counter this just because it gains life and it's gonna mess the race up. I noticed after I started to make my line that I was like in a little bit of trouble. Come on, what's going on here? Oh, is it not colorless? It is not colorless. Okay. Yeah, that's awkward. Because now the Ravager just gets moved on over there. It's an artifact, but it is black. I'm just going to fetch now. Because, like, they can kill me anyways, and I at least want the mana available. Block, and then I kill whatever they move it on to still. So I'm gonna fetch an island. We don't need a lot to actually like take the game over from here. That fatal push is actually probably gonna like do it. So I can thought scour them. Put on top. Actually, I'm just going to Serum Visions. Yeah, we should be in good shape now. So we draw the Fatal Push. We have Fatal Push Bolt. I think I just want this. Put this on top. Put this on top. And I'm going to push this right now. Because I don't want to give my opponent... I just want to give them the option. Like they're going to move this somewhere right here. I think if they were smart... Well, they can't really put it on this because this just brick walls it. And now the Mox Opal's turned off. So am I getting frisky? No. We're going to wait. Yeah, now we're in good shape.
We're drawing.
I can Thought Scour my opponent to draw the Death Shadow as well. Yeah. So this is coming in. I'm going to Thought Scour them. Draw the Shadow. And then we can't lose. I don't think we can lose from this position. Welding Jar. We're just going to keep this on the battlefield because it's the third artifact for this Mox Opal, so it's kind of like Stone Raining them too. Yeah. Because like, if they Mox Opal landed, they could have animated this and then double chumped, but out of the chumped out of the next one. So that was quick. I wonder if I need a card like Engineered Explosives in my sideboard for help in these blue control matchups, because it hits like Search for Azcanta, it hits Ruined Halo, and it hits Detention Sphere, which are over the Jeskai and the blue-white decks. I don't really know what it would be. If I was going to bring another... I was going to add Engineer Explosives to this deck. I think it would have come from the Liliana of the Veil, a Braid, Grim Lavamancer spot. Or maybe like a Disdainful Stroke. Because I also want it against the same decks that I want Stroke against. Besides like Tron and stuff. It's pretty good. There's a little conundrum about what I want this land to be. And I could just wait and lead on the swamp, which is what I think I'm going to do. I probably, like, I could just make it easy and make it blue-red. But, like, I hate getting a non-black land so early in the game. That is not normal, but I don't think it's necessarily bad. I was playing Baubles before I kind of, like, I moved away from Modern a little bit to do other stuff. And now that I'm back here, what is going on? Oh, so I'm playing like against a prison deck. Return up to, this is like Soul Sisters here. So return up to 3 target creature cards with Corona and 1 or less cards from graveyard to the battlefield. Then they put a card on top. So I'm just going to take this. These are with double snap. This is probably going to be tough to win here. 3 Gurmag, 1 Tasker. I just get like a full stop on Tasker when it can't get over most Tarmogoyfs. And it just doesn't trade with Reality Smasher. It's like a it's like a Martyr proc deck, but it's been a while since I've played those. Played against any of these. This game's gonna go long, and I don't really have the tools to slog through a lot of this removal. Someone on the Facebook page just commented on my post saying like no graveyard hate in the 75, and I think that that's an awkward draw. And I think that it's like it's right for these Death Shadow decks to not play graveyard hate, because oftentimes, Teemer Battle Rage is your best form of graveyard hate. You know, so you can kind of hedge. Like, there's going to be some of those value matchups where Teemer Battle Rage isn't good, like such like the Mardu Pyromancer deck. But, like, graveyard hate's not very good against Jeskai. Okay, we hit a Battle Rage, which Battle Rage is going to be good at some point. We have another Thought Scour. So, probably next turn, just going to go, like, Snap Inquisition to take a path to exile and then just get on the board. And make them, like, use a path to answer the Snapcaster Mage and just have something going on. Yeah, I just don't think it's really good for these Death Shadow decks to play cards, play graveyard hate, because you need to be focused on what you're doing, I think, and not be reactive to what your opponent's doing. Okay, that's a good draw, but we're still just going to get, we're going to get the Snapcaster Mage down. That's going to hit a Ranger of Eos, which they could have kept on top. That's like definitely in a range of cards that my opponent could have. It sucks that Ghost Quarter is like strip mine, but that's just kind of how our draw lined up. Okay, there's Martyr of Sands gone. And I can take Ghostly Prism with my Thoughtseize if I need to. Unless they decide to just smoke my... Oh, the Ghostly Prism. I thought that was the blink card. This game's gonna get much harder. I should have taken that one. I thought it was. I made a mistake with this, knowing what this card was. I thought they saw a 3-mana white card, and I thought the card that blinked everything. I just didn't take the time to read it. Okay, so yeah, definitely gonna take this Ranger. Yeah, now it's gonna be much more difficult to win here. Yeah, I just 100% right to take this card, not the Martyr of Sands. So that was super wrong. I thought it was the blink card, the card that shifts all your things out. That's what I, when I looked at it, I just like read that card. So my opponent is going to have to take care of this Snapcaster Mage at some point. Like, we're just not even going to let them... Like, they're going to path my Snapcaster Mage. We're not in, like, a super bad spot. Because, like, most of my opponent doesn't have a lot of synergies left in their deck from here. Like, from this... It's going to be tough for them to go off from this low of a base. Probably just not going to play my Death Shadow until my opponent uses at least one of their paths on this. My best draw would be like a Snapcaster. Yeah. No, I just like 100% just completely misread what the card was there. And just like now I'm in a lot of trouble because of it. Okay, Ranger's tough. Ranger's gonna make me move. Cause they probably get... Thraven Inspector. That's cool. The Thraven Inspector trades in my Snapcaster Mage too. Yeah, that's probably gonna happen at some point. They have two paths. I would like to find another Snapcaster Mage for a discard spell. Yep, yeah, there we did. Okay. So I'm gonna get in here and attack. Then Snapcaster and hit a Thoughtseize. And then I can start to like use a bolt on one of these Thraven Inspectors just to keep something going on. I guess I can just dismiss this. Just to keep on the board. Yeah, I'm just so super punished for... I mean, I guess we haven't been that punished because we still have to deal with all of these... all the... Whatever they are. Oh, no! Oh, my gosh, I tapped... Mistapped because I was talking. All right, well, we're going to try to fix this here. Now this game's just going to get so much harder. All right, well, at least we have a Gurmag Angler. So we have two paths and a Thraven Inspector that we know about. It is almost 11 o'clock. which is usually late for when I have to go out. They can actually bust both my red sources. So this is just like the complete nightmare scenario here. Okay, they didn't do that, which is good. This is just another Ranger of Eos, a Gideon. All right, well now we're just gonna bolt the token and then battle rage the Gideon. Just in such a more difficult spot now. Because I didn't snap a Thoughtseize last turn. Because I misclicked. Because I'm going to cycle this. I might find a discard spell. Alright, Overseer and Visions. Okay, so there's a discard spell and a Stubborn Denial. So put on the bottom, put on top. Thoughtseize one of their paths, and then next turn we can go nuts. We might still win this game, despite all of our muff ups. I can actually play both cards and have the mana for Stubborn Denial up while attacking, which is great. You'd have cast the Angler. I might be all over the place tonight. I am tired. They're gonna field something here. Which field is just a strip mine at this point. Alright, that's not bad. Oh, they shuffle away my... They shuffle that away. Alright, so I'm actually not going to attack because they don't want to pay the mana to do it. Oh, let's get rid of this. Just delve out my lands. They're just gonna play this. So they're gonna path my shadow or not. I played this game like a complete asshole. Now I'm just tired. I'm just like muffing this up here. They just didn't reveal. Oh, they're going to, yeah. They're gonna block and reveal, okay. At least we get to get in with our 5/5. Then we'll hold the Snapcaster back to trade with something. Tough to win. My opponent is through two of their Path to Exiles, though. I'm assuming they're playing four. You probably block here, right? And then path this. Unless I just don't know. I'm misinterpreting what their last card is. This gets path. There's no search. And then I'll just Thought Scour at the end of my opponent's turn. And then just pay for this Angler the rest of the game. That's the plan. Squat. They made a Squadron Hawk. Oh my god. That's literally like the worst draw. Oh my god, the Squadron Hawk is so bad. So that they can play two, four. They can just play all of them. They got six mana to get all the Squadron Hawks down. So now I need to draw a removal spell in order to live. I guess I deserve not win this game. This one has been poor enough play for me. I have not played well in this stream. Just gonna block. Oh, that Squadron Hawk was like the worst draw possible. I don't even think I have an out to this because I can't attack and hold up two removal spells. Because I'm not going to win the game going long against these Squadron Hawks. And I'm at too low of a life total. Which I undoubtedly could have saved. Like, I just played this game poorly enough where there's enough ways to save some life at some point. They're holding the last one. Okay, well, at least I get to get it. Maybe I'll get it out of their hand. They start playing around with like a removal spell here. Thank you, Max. I'm a fan of Death Shadow. Dark Player discards its card. It probably doesn't matter in the long run. Because like they attack me here, and then I don't have a draw in my deck that can deal with two of these. If I was up one more life, I'd have a chance. But I'm not. Or if I could rip Battle Rage and win, I'd have a chance. But my Angler's not enough power in order to do that. Alright, concede. You got it. Okay. So let's see if we can figure out how to not just toss this game here, these in this last league, or in this next match here. So these are great. These are great. The Lava Mancers are great. The counter spells are probably not super great. I don't know if my spot removal is where I want to be. Probably definitely don't want these dismembers. I'm not even sure I want all of my Snapcasters or my Gurmag Anglers, considering they're probably going to bring in Graveyard Hate. So if I go like... I mean, I could just go in like full nuts and like go full grind and try to just like also Liliana them out of the game. And just try to control the board with Planeswalkers and take out a lot of my aggression and like take out some spot removal and just try to play a long game. Because like they're going to bring in Graveyard Hate, so maybe I like hedge and board, bring in some cards that are good against Graveyard Hate. Like the Lava Mancer's not being good, but the Lava Mancer's just that good just in case they do. I'm going to buy the Snapcaster Mages is better than the Kolaghan's Command in this matchup. And I do think that Liliana of the Veil plus removal is good enough. What I'm wondering is if I want these two cards here. Do I even want all of my removal? Do I want all my discard, I mean? Like, the discard doesn't seem that great because their deck is so redundant. I actually really don't know how to sideboard in this matchup. I think I want to keep in this Snapcaster. I want to bring this Fatal Push in because Fatal Push even hits the Ascendant if it's a 6-6. I think I want to try something like this. Just be like removal dot deck and then win with like a Snapcaster Mage or a Planeswalker. Take over the game with like Gurmag Angler, Grim Lava Mancer or Liliana's. Because Grim Lava Mancer is like a Planeswalker in this matchup. I don't know how to sideboard this matchup. I'm going to give this a try. I haven't played against the Martyr Proc deck with Death Shadow in a long, or Grixis Death Shadow specifically, ever. I haven't played against it with Jun in a long time. So let's just see what we got here. Yep, we're gonna keep this. So maybe we get a Watery Grave on one. I'm very sure that if we can land like a last hope on a decent board, it should win us the game. Alright, I don't want the Angler. I do want the Blood Crypt. I'm going to save my Street Wraith until I need it. Which will probably be next turn. Next turn, because next turn I can go Seer Visions, cycle Street Wraith into Death Shadow. So just Steam Vents. I'm going to assume that Thoughtseize is going to be decent at some point. Like, you can hit, like, a Ranger. I could do that. Actually, I could fire that off right now in order to hit a Maru proc. I can't even play my Death Shadow because of Life Totals. Yeah, so we're going to go like this. That's why you hold your Street Wraiths when you play this deck. You don't just Street Wraith crazy. Okay, Wrath, Thalia, Day of Judgment, Ghostly Prison Ranger. I'm just going to take this Thalia. And we're going to land this Liliana the next turn and then be in good shape. The Ghostly Prison is going to be annoying, though. So maybe I should actually just take the Ghostly Prison because it trumps Liliana the Last Hope. Yeah. I can deal with the Thalia next turn. I go GQ into Thalia. Now I just want to get both of my shadows down. Well, I don't want to get both my shadows down into the face of both of these Wraths. So we'll just play one, kill the Thalia, and then play the Last Hope when I untap. I'm going to use the Bolt. Because if things go out of hand, they get the 6/6 lifelinker, I'm going to want my Fatal Pushes. It's not a bad draw. I'm going to get this Liliana going. Though, maybe hitting the Ranger is like that important. Well, even if they gain a bunch of life, I can just push the token. I can push the 6/6. So I'm just going to get this going. This is like another form of a clock. And they have to draw a land. They'd have had to draw a land, the two draw steps that I don't know about, including this one, in order to do that, so they did. I guess they get double Ranger, so I do need a Thoughtseize next turn. They just Wrath my Shadow. Okay. Alright. I did not see that coming. That is your prerogative, sir. So I kind of just want to take one of these Rangers. They can just day my shadows all day. If I need to bring them back, I can. I'm just going to play this land too in case we start getting into some Snapcaster shenanigans. We still have a 6/6 covered. There's the Ranger. Raven Inspector, Hangerback Walker. Okay. I guess I'll tick up on this, so then I can block this thing here, and we will just pass the turn. My opponent's got Plains, Day, Hangerback Walker. The Hangerback Walker is going to be annoying. Double Ghost Quarter as well. My opponent can Hangerback for 3, which is kind of gross. Hopefully my opponent does something like they get greedy and they try to like put a counter on it and then try to day away my shadows. Maybe that's like just the line to do here. So let's go like this. Go to 7. I'm going to play this Lavamancer, even though it plays into the Wrath, and just go block, block. And if my opponent tries to like Wrath out of it, then I can just push this Hangerback Walker and it clears their board as well. They play the Plains. Pop Clue. Tap your Hangerback Walker. Come on. Tap it and put a counter on that main phase. This is one of my favorite cards when it was in standard. Looks like they're going to do it. Yeah. Awesome. And then we just ult the Liliana. Okay, they're just going to play this Mardu proc. All right. Okay, so they're not going for it. And then we're just going to ult this Liliana and take our sweet time here. Now I think it's going to be difficult to lose. Though I do think I should shoot this. Yeah, I think I should shoot this now. Before my opponent gets the opportunity to draw more. Opponent's the opportunity to draw more white cards. And now it's just like an inevitability game. Okay, so dang. Oh, they ripped a Ghostly Prism. Okay. The Ghostly Prism is going to be annoying. We don't have a way to get it off the table. But. That does just trump the old Liliana. Another Ghostly Prism. Jeez. Okay. Creatures can't attack you. So we're just going to go like all the way with. With his Lavamancer. Yeah, I think we're just going to go all the way to the Lava Man. What do we got? We got 10 cards. We're going to need 22 cards in our graveyard. This is going to be one hell of a game. Imagine they draw like a Fumigate. They draw a Fumigate, they just can't win at all. At some point, but like I don't even know what I'm gonna do when they. Yeah, we're sending this upstairs. They have another Ghost Quarter, so they're going to also hit my. Hit my steam vents. I don't have any red sources. This is gonna be. It's just gonna be like impossible to win this game. I mean, it's not gonna be impossible, but it is not going to be fun. Just slogging through these Ghostly Prisms. I guess I could be attacking with like two of my zombies every turn. It's like one gets chumped and then they just one like either trades or gets in some damage. I don't want to attack with my Death Shadow because the Death Shadow allows him to pop his hanger back. Yeah, I guess I'm just going to start attacking with two zombies. This is going to be such an annoying game. Oh, we have to do 8? Yeah, we're not. I don't know. I can't win. Right? Like, I literally can't win this game. I don't have any red sources left. I have to draw Liliana the Veil. And then edict away these prisons. What a game. This ghostly prism is going to beat my Liliana Last Hope emblem.
Yep, we're just gonna pass. I could just concede this game to like have more positive life EV. Cause I do think I'm gonna win. Because, like, I think the Lilianas will be able to eventually. Okay, so they're going for the Wrath play. Yeah, so I don't really. It's going to be tough either way. At least now the board's clear and I can start attacking with like my Death Shadow next turn. My opponent's out of cards, which is nice. I can pay for a shadow to get in. All right, Radiant Flames. It's 100% castable. We don't need Thought Seizes, we don't need Street Wraiths, we don't need lands. So now we just get him in there for 7 every turn. Oh, I love how the Angler upkeep if you control. Oh, wow. This is just every turn they get back. And they just have an infinite chump blocker. They just get this back every turn. You don't have to sack it. So what is, this means like now I actually can't win, right? Because I just keep doing this. Thraven Inspector and Hangar Backwalker. Oh my god. This is unreal. I don't think I can win. So I think we're just gonna move on here. I think I could like I could probably try and time my opponent out here, which just really isn't worth it for like a viewing pleasure. Why don't they just go get a Sarah Ascendant? I guess they have another Ranger. If my opponent shows me a way they can kill me easily, then I'll scoop this up. Because my only way of winning this game is to time them out at this point. Like, show me the 1/1s that gain a bunch of life. Okay, all right, we're good. What a weird game. This would be so, yes, I agree. I thought we had a chance, but I guess I should have seen through that, that whatever it is. That, gosh, I can't even think. I should have seen through that Emeria, the land. See if we can run off 3 in a row here and have a good end to it. I would like to play first.
I think I'm going to keep this hand. I could see this definitely, like, bricking and dying, but it doesn't take a lot for us to get a Gurmag Angler in play pretty quickly. I get two shots at a land, and I have a discard spell, and, like, more things I can do even on one land. So we're just going to try this out. Okay. So we're playing against Eldrazi Tron. So they just have natural Karn rolled up. So I'm just going to take this Relic. And then we're going to have to stub this Karn. This is the much worse Tron deck in my... No, this is actually regular Tron. I thought this was... It's a different art. So I thought this was some different Urza's Mine. This is like the... Like if you're in a metagame modern, this is the metagame deck to play. Because this deck beats up on all the decks that beat up on humans. So if you're ever going to, you know, do the metagame, oh man, what a... We drew a land, but it wasn't the one we needed. And that actually throws us off quite a bit if we don't draw another land, because we can't play Angler and stub Karn. Which is going to be all sorts of sadness. I have three push, or three bolts, two pushes, two dismembers, and I don't have any terminates. Okay, the map's good. All right, we need a land bad. Oh my gosh. All right, we'll pass. I'm gonna stub my opponent's next play, which is gonna allow me to play Angler, then stub something again. So we just gotta hope my opponent doesn't have like running scary stuff. One of their cards is a Hangar Backwalker, which might at some point get large enough to trade with my Angler, which is gonna suck. Power plant means no Ugin. The Hangar Backwalker meme here, I can just push it. Then they'll probably shoot me. Yeah. But like, we can't really beat that, right? That's not good either. We're going to take one more draw step. Let that one go. We're going to take one more draw step, because if I draw a discard spell for the Ballista, I might actually kind of be in it, because we have Death Shadow plus Battle Rage, which sometimes can overpower a Wyrmcoil Engine. Alright, so we're going to let this resolve. Let's hit this one more time. So we hit a land, which doesn't do anything. One, two, three. Goes and gets the Sanctum. Yeah, we can't. The Death Shadow's gonna... Yeah, we're just gonna scoop this one up here. I can play this one out for like the 1%er. Like at a tournament, I would play this out, but I don't think I'm gonna play this out here. Because like my play is to take another shot from this, go to 11. They play a million Walking Ballista, then play a Death Shadow. My opponent's at like 32 life, so it needs to take two swings while it has to keep getting chumped. So it's just like the life EV is better by doing it this way. So let's get these over here. I'm going to cut just some creature removal. Keep the command, cut this, and shave an Angler. I keep a Snapcaster Mage because you can just flash a Snapcaster Mage in if you need to. I would like to play first. I will keep this hand. So how do I sequence here? Do I just Serum Visions on one? Do I hold my Street Wraith so I can find a land next turn off of my Scries? I think I Serum Visions, and I think I hold my Street Wraith. Okay, Death Shadow, Thought Scour. I don't think I want either of these. I think I need a way to enable this Death Shadow. If my top card is like fetch land, then if I keep this, it's insane. But if it's not a fetch land, it's not that good. Yeah, I think I'm gonna put this on the bottom. Okay, there's a Chromatic Star. Okay. Alright, now I'm sad. Alright, so here's Death Shadow. Hold the Thought Scour. Then I can like snap Serum Visions if I need to next turn. I appreciate everybody for being here and hanging out tonight. I hope you're all having a good time. I'd love to be able to stub that. There's nothing that makes me happier than stubbing cantrips. So I think if you don't cast an early interactive spell in a matchup, it's pretty rough for the Shadow. They have a lot of hands to keep their like true drawn lands mass crying. Yeah, I agree. I think this is just a very good deck. What do they do? They got a Chromatic Star. Okay. Alright, so we drew a stub. Pretty good. Fortunately, we did not draw a way to. We can draw like a. We can keep the cards flowing. But I have to hold up. I can't like just go snap Serum Visions here. I just gotta go snap and hold the. Hold up Stubborn Denial for Karn. This is like a very poor hand for my opponent too. We're struggling to beat it up. I'm definitely gonna hit a map if my opponent plays a map or plays a Sylvan Scrying here. All right, we're gonna let that one go. It doesn't take a lot for me to kill my opponent. Urza's Tower, okay. Into Oblivion Stone. So I think I'm going to still run this Snapcaster Mage out here. Because I do need to get the cards flowing. And if I find something like an Abrade, I can Abrade this and then still have Stubborn Denial up. Okay, so I found the Abrade, step one. Wow, that's actually pretty good. So let's destroy target artifact. Make sure I point the right one here. So let's start with this. This turns makes my stub live too. Yeah, that was a pretty sick set of draw steps there. That was a good one. Now if I find a way to deal damage to myself, my opponent's actually dead. Unless they hit another Wyrmcoil Engine. Alright, so now I need a way to deal damage to myself. No, that doesn't quite do it. I mean, it's pretty good, but it still doesn't quite get me over the hump. I mean, we got super lucky there. We got lucky enough to turn on, like, our two draws. We had to hit our one outer and hit a way to deal damage to ourselves. I guess we could have hit K-Command, but, like, could have hit K-Command as well. I think I'm going to be streaming this deck all week this week. All right, we're going to keep this hand. Start off with our discard spells. Hopefully we can find a way to get a quick angler. Just something to sneak in there with a mana. Why don't my opponent mulligan more? Alright. At least that's the land that's... It's going to, well, I guess it's not, I mean, it's going to add to Delve, I guess, but there's, that was a pretty piss poor draw. Okay, we miss. All right, it's kind of a loose keep for my opponent. They effectively made us mulligan, which makes me sad. I do have to take that Karn. So they kind of need to hit. There's the tower. Don't Sylvan Scrying, dude. Come on. They hit the Sylvan Scrying. That is so... I just blitzed on one. Thank God. Okay, so... it doesn't really matter how I sequence my cantrips here. Because I have to take Karn. It would be interesting to think about, like, what I would do if I could, if I didn't have to take this Karn. Oh, now we have the decision. I think I'm gonna take Karn, because I have a Braid to help fight through the Wormcoil engine. But I want to, I sincerely hope my opponent doesn't find a way to get Tron next turn. Put on the bottom. Battle Rage, I mean, we've drawn poorly off of this couple draws here. This Battle Rage seems slow, though. If I had a Death Shadow, I would keep it, but I think I'm going to put it on the bottom. Okay, so they didn't hit. They didn't hit O-Stone, which we can deal with O-Stone. We're just going to play the Angler here. I'm gonna play the Angler, I'm just gonna blow this up. I'm not gonna. I don't think I'm gonna play around the Worm Coil. I guess I'm going to do this first. Because if I hit a Snapcaster, I wouldn't mind. I would not mind Thought Seizing the Worm Coil. Yeah, that's what I thought. I thought it was a poor keep. I dealt everything with a... Yeah, I think it was too. I mean, my hand has not come together. Now I just gotta hope my opponent doesn't hit. I mean, Ancient Stirrings is basically hitting. Because this is the most busted cantrip in Modern. No mine. No mine. Come on. Don't hit a mine. Come on. They hit a Chromatic Sphere. Nice. Popping it. Oh, that's pretty sweet. It's kind of sweet. It's not like super sweet. I guess I'm just going like shatter shock my opponent, and then I hit them for. Like, I think shocking them is actually just a more value than. Yeah, I'm pretty sure shocking my opponent. Like, I'm gonna wait for them to put invest mana into this. Actually, I'm just gonna do it now. I don't want them to like pump this and begin to like get in some awkward damage race here, where they top deck another one, then I'm in trouble. I'm just gonna take it. Okay. I did not think they were gonna block there. That makes this play even much worse from my perspective. I just didn't even think about that at all. I figured they were just going to take it, and then they were going to look to put counters on it and then, like, come back at us. Okay. I'm not playing super well tonight, also, and it's late. So, they probably ditch into the log. It's pretty easy. Alright, it's a good draw. Now we're just gonna chug along here with Nasty. Okay, there's the power plant. Unfortunately, we have to counter this, I think. Because one more land means that. Okay, so they got Wyrmcoil Engine, Ulamog is the only cards in their hand. So as long as they don't hit a Tron piece. Don't hit the Tron piece, come on. Come on. There's the line. So there's 9. Now we're just super dead. I played the Wyrmcoil. Oh, okay. Because I couldn't play the Ulamog, right? Alright, well. Yeah, this doesn't matter. Yeah, Snap Command would have been nice. Oh man, that was just not good. But yeah, we win the first one each time. Now we've gotten smoked. Actually, I'm going to call it a night. I have to get up probably around 6. I got to get up in like 6.5 hours. I'm pretty tired. So, I'm going to bring this deck back again. Tomorrow. Today was a rough stream. We got beat up today. But yeah, I like the deck still. I need to figure out, like, I'm probably gonna play this main deck. The only thing I could change is maybe adding another red source. I only have 2 red sources in my deck because I cut the Anger of the Gods. You did just come in here, but I have to be up at 6 o'clock Eastern. It's 11:30 now. But I do want to make, I am going to have to work a little bit with some of this. I want to make a cohesive sideboard plan, which is going to, I don't know if I'll do that while I'm streaming. It's going to cause me like moving cards in and out. I think K-Command's okay. Like, I feel like K-Command is a nice main deck card because, like, you got Snapcaster Mages, but I think it grinds worse. I think it's like worse than all of these cards here. I'm gonna stop recording. I'm gonna stop recording.